Good morning, dear participants. Today, as I have already started in the introduction, we are having Mr. Yatrik Patel. He is the scientist from Infibinet, Gujarat. He would be talking about the library systems we have to have in the colleges, the technologies which have been developed in the library area, and other subjects related to library. So I would like to welcome, on behalf of the Self-Financing College Management Association and the Principal Welfare Cell, I would like to welcome our resource person, Mr. Yatrik Patel, for this webinar session. Good morning to you.
Thank you.
Sir.
Very good morning to everyone.
Thank you, sir. So I would request Mr. Yatrik Patel to take over the session and continue. Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Well, good morning to everyone. I will be taking care of today's session, and in which, first of all, the role of library is getting changed. So for few slides, I'll be talking about what should a library be. And it should be according to your user, and then what is coming up in next few years, and what will be the expectation of the user, and what are the tools and technologies available in the academic era which we can utilize. I would like to go through my presentation. So first of all, let us talk about, I will be little quick today because we are already late by 10, somewhere around 15 minutes, and I will try to finish it in next 45 minutes. There is a misconception, or whenever we see the people, including us like academician, we see that and there are questions, are library dying? What is role of library nowadays, when you can get everything on this mobile device or everything on your laptop, everything is available electronically. But secondly, pattern is also less dependent on the Google and internet. And traditional libraries doesn't provide any space for interaction. What is happening, somebody has shared an interesting article on Twitter or Facebook, and people debate on merits and demerits of article. You cannot do that in library. So the question is, are library dying? But I will say that libraries are not dying, but libraries are evolving, because you see, still everything is not available on internet. Again, digital libraries are not the internet. Library is not just about books, it is many more things. Secondly, whatever you find in internet, the quality control does not exist. What we are talking is, libraries are not dying but evolving, because you find lot of material on internet, but quality control doesn't exist. You cannot cite each and everything what is available on internet. And the advancement in mobile devices is not end of books or libraries. So please remove this misconception. And actually speaking, the nowadays libraries are more relevant in current era, because it walks a fine line between printed and online material. Then it provides environment to learn, and moreover, the librarians who are having specialist knowledge, and they are trained to find reliable information and evaluate it, and to supply the user. But there is a paradigm shift. There is a paradigm shift in which, so far if you see, the libraries or world culture of libraries were evolving around their collection. They were always keen on maintaining their like reference materials, their OPEC, their collection, the classification, etc. It was collection oriented. But now the transformation is you have to be, or librarian have to be, user and service oriented. And when I say user oriented, we should 100% see that the which kind of user that we are going to serve, right? And we know whom we are going to serve in next 5 years or 10 years. That is people born in 2000 or maybe people born in 2005. So whom we are going to serve? We are going to serve Generation Z or the Alpha generation for next 10 years. Now, you all are aware about characteristic of this generation. You know, these fellows are multitaskers. They always chat. Again, they always talk. Again, they are always video talking. They easily do multiple things simultaneously. They are always connected. Okay, they know from where they can get their resources, maybe right or wrong. And if they don't find something, you know, they will immediately collaborate with each and every other. I will give you some a little example. Like in schools, what is happening, a teacher, or even rather in colleges, what is happening? Okay, there is whenever a teacher says you have to create a project, so immediately a WhatsApp group will be created. WhatsApp group will be created, and then within that WhatsApp group, information will be exchanged. There will be debates, there will be discussion, there will be strategies. Okay, these facilities were not available when we, or particularly I, was a student. So this generation is digital native. They are more collaborative. They are tech savvy. And you have to, or as a librarian, have to serve this kind of user. And you know that this typical characteristics of the user, this user is more tech savvy than us, or than librarian. And they have typical mindset. You know, we are the generation. We have grown by watching TVs and cinemas, but this generation, they even don't watch TV. They want they watch web series, right? And according to one survey, more than 4 out of 5 people sleep along with their mobile phone. So this, as a librarian, you have to serve this tech savvy generation. So to serve new breed of user, transformation is only the option. Again, technological advancements in information management will put pressure on libraries to innovate their infrastructure and operational skill. You know, keep this in mind. Information management needs to be taken care, infrastructure needs to be updated, and operational skills to be updated. So library has to be adaptive for application based on augmented reality or artificial intelligence. And now I'm not going to talk here much about AI or machine learning, but just to brief that when we say intelligence, it is ability to interact with the world, that is speech, vision, and motion, and ability to model the world and to give reason about it. Okay, this, and to understand artificial intelligence, one can say that okay, these are the programs that behave externally like humans, programs that operate internally as humans do, and computational system that behave intelligently. Now, you might be thinking, what this guy is talking about, where where is library and how you can apply artificial intelligence in that. I will show you an example. Say how it applies to library. Just assume a future library when one user, just as soon as he enters into library, there is a screen. Now user is being identified by his biometric devices or RFID scan. So the library system will know, okay, Yatrik, or say my user has entered into library, and my system will greet me. Okay, hi Yatrik, good morning, welcome to Soul. Soul is basically name of library management system. How I can help you? User will say, just speech to text recognition, speech synthesis. Okay, library system user, tell me what is new for me. Immediately system should respond, okay, you have one unfinished book on artificial intelligence. Sorry, there are two new articles on big data for you. There is a latest book on library of future is available on display rack. Tell me, what do you want to do? And I will say as a user, okay, so send article links to my email, thank you, and that's it. So this is how a library management system with inbuilt AI, artificial intelligence, should work. Secondly, okay, now regarding this library management system, I will be going to give you a brief, maybe after next two, three slides, but let me finish or continue this topic. Secondly, there are library robots which will arrange the books according to their classification. As well as robots also can be used to deliver the books. And see, these are not very like fancy things or very high profile things. These are simple machines and it can work for you very easily. And then people are thinking, okay, now say my physical collection is shrinking. Okay, say when I order 100 books, say out of 100 books, my 25% books are in electronic collection, and day by day my physical collection is shrinking. So in that case, you have to utilize your physical space for better facility to users. See, from starting and beginning, I'm telling, try to be user centric. So what we have to give to user, like comfort, convenience, and a quiet individual study rooms. There should be spaces for group introduction, group discussion, group interaction. There should be spaces like 3D printers and augmented reality kind of thing, where user can experiment and do innovation. There should be space where user can sit and discuss, and this all should be within library. So there is a concept of library as space. So you know, it constantly evolves like this. Say new users demands new services. New services demands new spaces. You create those spaces. Then after 5 years, new set of users will come. Again, they will demand new services. Again, you have to. So this cycle is evolving. Now, I was talking about library management software. Just a minute. There is, yeah. When we say library management software, what one should expect? So it should be simple and easy with minimum complexity. It should help you in increase library engagement. It should give you efficient data management. It should be highly reliable and scalable. you should be able to access on any device. There should be dynamic reports, because you know, for people like us, or say college librarians, reports are very, very customization in reports are very, very important, because you know, our authorities, they ask anything at any time, like particularly whenever NAC is supposed to come, or whenever you want to need some finance, whenever you want to put some project, they will obviously say, give me subject wise, user wise access of library, or give me how many books you have in digital collection, or tell me how many books you have in applied physics. So your system should be such that it should give you the reports. So it should be customizable and it should be cost effective. The SOUL is SOUL, the Software for University Library, is such system which has been designed using client server architecture. It is multi-user with unlimited access. It supports all the standards like MARC 21, CCOF, ISO, AACR2. It requires minimum training. It has built-in SMS and email alert, and it is full compliant with RFID. It provides comprehensive list of reports and fully tested and implemented by number of universities, colleges, and other institutions. So rather than going to the screen, I'll straight away show you the dashboard. Now, see, as soon as you enter into your library management, see, I'm talking of from the perspective of librarian or principal. Okay, not from the users at present. So as soon as a librarian or principal or whomsoever college staff logs in, he will see on dashboard, he will immediately see, say, there are how many total members, what is total collection of the libraries, what are the books which are pending from order, what are the last accession numbers. So all this information you will get on your dashboard. Secondly, like this software has been made in a way that you can use your languages. At present, we have done a translation in Hindi as well as English. Assamese we are working on, Gujarati we are working on, and definitely we will convert into all Indian languages, including Tamil, Malayalam, Kannada, Telugu, all. This software is having a versatile web OPEC. So basically, the web interface, you can access it from anywhere. Because see, say when a student is roaming in the campus or library, you cannot expect him to carry a laptop or a desktop device every time. He should get all his library services on mobile. So you can see the screen. You are having OPEC has been made in a way that it is like it is having facets by subject, authors, publishers, and all. You can see it's on a mobile screen. Second benefit, particularly in current area, see what is happening in this Indian education system. As soon as a student gets admission, he is being asked to fill up, go to the library, fill in the form, submit to librarian, and come after 2 days, so, or say come after a certain time, so that he can get his library member card. But here what we facilitate you is, if your college is online, like your system is online, a member can directly register, and fill in the form. He can upload his photograph and fee receipts and signatures. And once librarian approves, okay, this is the valid member after looking into the attach document, and he says, okay, so his membership form will be or his membership will be created automatically. So earlier what was happening, say there are 500, 700 or maybe 1000 students. So during admission season, librarian is always busy in filling up and accepting membership forms. Again, he has to collect the membership form, which is hard filled, and then enter into the system. Now here, member himself will enter into the system, and only thing librarian has to do is to approve the same. So this is done. This software supports all global prevailing standard, that is MARC 21, MARC XML, ACR2, CCF, etc. This software is having native compliance to RFID. So, and it is supporting basically ANSIP 2.0 as well as SIP 2.0 protocol, SIP 2 protocol. See, basically these protocols are international standards, so you are not vendor bound. Otherwise, so for libraries and for bigger systems, what happens? Okay, you have got the magnetic tape from this brand. Now for entire lifetime, you have to buy equipments from this vendor only. Otherwise, if you buy from another vendor, it may not work. But this is not the case with Soul. It is compliant to international standards. So whenever you buy any hardware tag or any RFID tag, only thing you have to make sure is whether it is ANSIP 2 compliant or not. And once it is done, you can do or entire automated operation like automated issue, automated return, self-check-in, book drop, stock verification. Everything will be done in hours. And additionally, what is happening? Say other vendors are charging for this integration and middle tier and etc. But with Soul software, you are getting it bundled. Why? Because see, Soul is not profit making. Basically, my organization comes under University Grants Commission. We are not profit making bodies. We just want to serve the higher education community. Well, it catalogs anything. This is the data entry sheet. If somebody is interested, or I will skip. More benefit I would like to tell you is, see, a person or a librarian, it takes average 12 to 18 minutes to enter a book record. If he really capture all the fields means, that is, see, what as a layman, what we understand is a book means title, author, publisher, year of edition, ISBN number, and that's it. It is not like that. When you ask a librarian, he will definitely tell you what a book means. He say there is a title, there is a unique title, there is a parallel title, then there is an author, there is a corporate body, there is first author, then there is role of author, then there are keywords, then there is physical description, then there is remarks, then there is notes, then there is series statement. Lot many fields are there, and your record will be complete only if you enter all the available field according to standard. Now here in Soul, what is happening? Say a quality record creation normally takes 12 to 18 minutes for an expert librarian. Okay, so suppose if somebody orders 500 books, so you just imagine 500 multiplied by 20 minutes are gone just to catalog their book. But what feature Soul provides, like you just get copy of your book, find it out from somewhere, either it is from Union Catalog of InfibNet, or even if it is from WorldCat, or if it is from some other catalog, just select that record and import it into your library management system. So your whole effort of data entry will be saved, and what you will get quality records. Further, it also provides customizable templates for data entry. It also provides customizable reports, like you can design your own report. I'm not sure whether you can see it on the screen, but you can design your own reports as per your requirement, as per your desire, and print it. You can export this reports into Word, PDF, Excel, etc. One major benefit with this software is it is for circulation window. For circulation window, one needs to do all transaction from a single screen, because you cannot expect a person who is sitting on circulation to do multiple processes, because a member or user should be served first. So we have designed a unique transaction system in which from a single window you can do issue, return, renewal, reserve, on premises issue, lost transaction, missing transaction, or withdrawal of book, everything from a single screen. So from user point of view, you don't need to go back and forth. We have support centers all across the country. These are the pricings. I will skip at present. I would mention some success stories. Like this software has been installed in somewhere around 3700 locations in the country, and this makes most installed library management software as of now, a single software. If you see Gujarat Vidyapeeth Library, which is a public library also, they have 5 lakh records. And here we have implemented Soul with localization. Then there is a typical infrastructure like Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. They have 5 lakh plus records. And moreover, they have multiple departmental libraries. They have 135 department library as such. So issue return is happening and procurement, etc. is happening from department library as well as central library. And they were not happy with all big giants, that is Libsys or NewgenLib or even Koha. And they used it for a certain time, and then after, as they were not happy, they migrated to Soul. University of Mumbai, 8 lakh records. Whether I have mentioned or not, yeah. University of Madras is also using this software. And if you see, there are 5 oldest universities of the country, that is University of Madras, University of Kolkata, University of Mumbai, and this Banaras Hindu. All 5 oldest university of this country is using our software, and that is proud for us. So this achievements, etc., I will skip. But what I would like to say is that state government of Madhya Pradesh, Haryana, Andhra Pradesh have fully automated their library using this software. And in certain library schools, this software is being taught as a syllabus. So you can understand the standard of the software. Now I would like to take, although I think 10:45, but I would like to take five more minutes. If you can recall the presentation by my colleague Mr. Raja, he has emphasized on open access and putting your content into open environment, right? Like, and what he has told is, or even what we want to say is, if you put your content which is easily available to the general public for reference or for study, like you put your papers, you put your articles into the public, and definitely it will be searchable by Google, and you will get more citation, you will get more citation bins, you will get more APIs. Further, as you will get more citations, definitely your institute will also get more citation, your H index will be more, and everyone will grow. And the idea was to put the content into open access. But the question is how? So there is something called, I will be not taking whatever has been covered by my colleague Mr. Raja. I think he was speaker in this seminar, maybe second or third one, I'm not sure. But here I will talk about institutional repository. Institutional repositories are basically a mechanism that creates and captures the digital digital intellectual output of an organization for long-term preservation. Now, say, what do you mean by intellectual output of an organization? Intellectual output of an organization is the content or the produces or the research or the papers or the theses or maybe the lecture which has been created by that institute. So all this should be available at one single place. So so once you put your content into your institutional repository, so you are 100% sure that your digital output will be curated. Again, they open up the research output of a university or institution to the world, and you will get more visibility and more impact. Secondly, it manages and measures research and academic activity. It enables and encourage interdisciplinary approach to research. And you know it is fun, like when your output, when your article is in public, there will be a separate debate, okay, whether we can put your article in public or not. But I'm sure my colleague might have told you 81% of the publisher in this world says you can put your article on your institutional repository. I will show you a brief this thing. Say this is an example of institutional repository of one college in or one university, Open University in Assam. What they have done, they have put everything, faculty publication, their journal, their PhD thesis on internet. Here you can search by authors, here you can search by other parameters, years. If you look at faculty publication and say title, now see, these are the articles published by their faculties, and it is publicly available, right? It was published in the Clarion, and anybody can see this article. So what is the benefit of this? approach. Idea is your entire content will be available on the net for the public consumption, and definitely as your consumption or your access will be more, your visibility more, you are going to get more citation. This is the arrangement. I mean, you can arrange your content in community, sub-community, collection and item. So basically what I meant to say is you can organize your content hierarchically, but only thing, you have to make a policy, an institution-wise policy that addresses what kind of content will be there in the repository, who will be able to put into the repository, because you know, otherwise you make everything public, then also things loses its importance. If somebody tells you, okay, please put message by principal, or please put photograph of annual event, these are not academic, right? So you have to make a policy, okay, what will go in my institutional repositories, who will regulate it, what will be the structure of repository, and what content and how content will be deposited, who will manage and who will access. So InfliNet also provides hosting services for such kind of activities. And with this, I think I will end my presentation. I have a few questions. Mohammed Sarajas says, which one is the best? Yeah, which one is the best library system, Koha or Soul? See, I will tell you. Koha is an open source, but initiated by a group from New Zealand, and then it has been made open source. We have one-to-one comparison. We have one-to-one comparison between Koha and Soul. I can send you via email. Secondly, Soul is made in India. Third point is, yes, Koha is good if you can do everything yourself, like its customization, its installation, its other things, then Koha is good. But if you are going to pay somebody to do it for you, then it is useless. Because see, what is happening in open source software, they have made this thing as a commercial one. Like they charge for installation, they charge for customization, they charge for internal maintenance, and then what is fun of open source, right? So like people are paying lakhs of rupees for Koha just to get it installed and just to customize. So feature and function wise, we have one-to-one comparison. Do mail me, I will send you all the details. And I will say Soul is better compared to Koha based on that comparison. Then Shiva Prakash ji says, what is cost of Soul? The cost for university unlimited version is available at 80,000. For college libraries, it is available at 50,000. Now, once you purchase it, we do lifetime upgrade free of cost. We do provide support free of cost. We do give you training free of cost. Those who purchased Soul in 2000, we have upgraded them to Soul 2.0 in 2009. That was free of cost, and we are going to upgrade with Soul 3.0. That is also free of cost. So it is just a seed money that we are taking. Even our annual maintenance charges, if somebody is keen, AMCs are very low, like 10,000 per year or so. This has been done. Then there is Madam Kavita says, clarification of eSource Sindhu and NList. Okay, eShodh Sindhu is entire project. Okay, so eShodh Sindhu covers, so basically you are aware about eShodh Sindhu, that it provides e-resources to Indian academic community, right? Now, as a whole, it is like the scope of ESS is all higher education institute, but for colleges which may, or undergraduate colleges which may not require resources as a university requires, so that is a little bit scaled down version of eShodh Sindhu, and that is being given to colleges, and it is called ENLIS. So I think this is done then there is a question. I will take one or two more questions maybe for next 2-3 minutes. Madam Dr. Gunawati says many resources are going to OPEC, Delnet, most of us using online resources. And how, please share your opinion. Ma'am, my opinion is too long. I would like to mail you separately, or please mail me separately for this, and I will give point-wise answer, and I will be happy to debate. But yes, ma'am, I will definitely answer your question, because you know, if I go and answer this question, it may eat away by 10-15 minutes, because this is like a very lovely topic for me to debate about future and technologies. So this is done. Are you recommending library professional? I'm not getting this question, sir. Yes, does that yes, it can be easily integrated with any software. We have APIs, so it can integrated with any software. No. Then there is from Samir. Yes, we are providing. So I think I am done with almost all questions.
Can you hear me?
Yes, sir.
Questions to you, sir.
Pardon?
Can I put the questions to you?
Sure, sir.
The first question is, what about the AMC in the, what did they ask about AMC? What about the AMC of this software?
Okay, see, there are two models for the AMC. One is on-call model. So in case if we are providing support from InfliNet Center, and that is remote support, we don't charge anything. Okay, but if you need some person at your place for some work, in that case you have to pay bus fare or train fare for that person, and say 1,000 rupees per visit, and the person will be traveling from either from Andhra or maybe from Karnataka. So AMC charges.
So are you providing any trial version?
Yes, sir. Trial version is available, and it is downloadable from our website. Trial version is limited to 500 records.
500?
Records.
500.
I mean, yeah.
How many days is it we can use the trial version, sir?
N number of times.
Okay, sir.
There is no limitation in time.
Okay.
But there is limitation in records.
Okay. If digital library, where we have access the resource library or lab? I don't understand the question. If
I'm not getting this
library
question.
Where we have to access the resource library or lab. I would request all the participants to kindly put their name, the college name, and the designation before you put up the questions. I would not ask the questions where their designation is not mentioned. Thank you, participants. So the next question is, what is your idea about Delnet?
Well, Delnet is good, but see, as an organization, I should not and I cannot comment on some other organization. Yes, they are doing good services. That's what I can say.
Okay, sir. So please clarify the disadvantages of RFID.
See, disadvantages of RFID is, the first one is the dependence. Okay, when you are fully, you cannot fully rely to RFID. Say, suppose there is an RFID tag and some mischievous student wraps it into a aluminum, I'm not giving idea, but I'm giving you the threat. If somebody wraps RFID into aluminum foil or carbon paper, sometime it doesn't work. And there are chances that keep books or your resources may be theft that way. So you have to have some other system also. So nothing, no system is foolproof, let me tell you.
Okay, sir. So they are asking the Infibinet to send the details to all library and mail IDs. But I don't think we will have library and mail IDs. What I could do is, sir, if you could send the details to our mail ID, we can post it to all the college principals.
Sure, sir.
Have access to all the college principals. Maybe the college principals can take it forward with their concerned librarians, sir.
Sure, sir. We can sir. I'll be doing that.
Any more questions, participants, so that we can wrap up the session? Okay. Is it compatible with all OS, Mac and Linux?
See, browser-based operations are compatible with all OS. I mean, that is obvious. But right now, the current version, the server can be on any thing which can host MS SQL or MySQL. So server can be Linux or Windows, but client 100% Windows, Microsoft. For that, we are coming up with new version, which will be platform independent.
The next question is, the utilization report is incomplete, incorporated all downloads like papers, books, etc.?
Yes, sir. See, the library management software has its own utilization report. It cannot tell you that how many articles have been downloaded, but yes, it can tell you how many books have been issued or how many books can be cataloged. So reports are comprehensive.
No, sir. We are downloading articles from Enlist, right, sir?
Okay. The question is related to Enlist.
Yeah.
Yes, sir.
So can will it be showing when we do when we take a utilization report? Will it give the Enlist download details?
Yes, sir.
It would give.
Yes, sir. Yeah, it will give. It will give. You have to specifically ask.
You have to specifically ask.
Specifically ask to Enlist, I mean the Enlist division.
Okay, sir. So thank you very much, sir. What I would do is, as I said, we will, once the session is over, you can give your mail ID, sir. We will pass it in to all the college principals and also the college managements, because we are using your software, sir. We are using your sole software.
That's great.
We find it very useful, and it's a really good software. We have been using it for the last 6 months or something.
And that's great, sir.
We are using it. So it's a software which we recommend to all the colleges also to buy. And thank you very much, sir, for your time.
Thank you.
And we would definitely be in touch with you. I think you have given your mail ID also. Yatrik at
infibinet.ac.in. That is to all the panelists. That is to all the panelists, but it should go to all participants.
Okay, I will. That's what I'll repeat. The mail ID to everyone. You can also post it to all the.
Yeah, I have done it. I have done it.
You can post. So there's one more question. I think someone has asked. 1 minute, sir. If digital library, where we have access to resource library or lab.
I'm not getting this question.
Yeah, this question also. If digital library, do we have access to resource library or lab? I think that could be the question. So what since you say, I heard you saying that the physical stock in the library is not needed, but during the NAC visit, they insist on the physical books. What is the percentage we can have in number of physical and digital. Is there any?
No. There is no predefined limit. See, what NAC is asking, ki you should have at least this much volume of book. Now they are not so keen on physical and electronic. Okay, earlier, before 5 years, they were keen. Okay, you must have this many volumes and this many collection. But nowadays, if you say you have subscribed to Analyst and additionally you have subscribed to this resources, I think it is done. Only thing you have to show is the utilization.
So you mean, sir, maybe in 5 years from now, there will be no more need for buying books. It's only a room is enough and we can have a digital library. Can we do that?
No, sir, not at all. See, book will always have its space. Okay. And always have its filling. Okay. This I am keeping with me, although I'm talking about this, but it cannot replace, at least for next 10 years, it cannot replace. Okay. But see, we cannot say about the people who are just born 10 years ago. Okay. The people who are born in 2010, you are not sure about them, whether they will like book or not, because we have never given them book. We have given them mobile.
Yes, sir. You're perfectly right. Perfectly right. Okay, sir. Thank you. Thank you very much, sir, for your time. And we will keep in touch with you, sir. Thank you, sir.
Sure, sir. Sure. Thank you, everyone. Thank you.